Welcome to the ELECTROLEDGE, where the knowledge makes effect. So today we are going to discuss the Zener diode. So first of all, Zener diode. What is mean by Zener diode? A Zener diode is a reverse bias heavily doped p-n junction diode which operates in a breakdown region. So please note this, which operates in a breakdown region. So let's draw the p-n junction diode. This is a p-type material and this is a n-type material. And we all show this, that it's Zener diode is a reverse bias heavily doped diode. So the both p-n junction must be heavily doped, and it should be a reverse bias, means the positive terminal of the battery is connected to the n-type of material and negative terminal of the battery is connected to the p-type of material. Therefore, this become a reverse bias circuitry of the Zener diode. So when a reverse voltage is applied to the p-n junction is increased, so when this reverse bias is applied, the p-n junction will be increased, the layer of the p-n junction will be increased. A value is reached at which the current increases greatly from the normal cutoff value. This voltage is known as the Zener voltage. So let's move to the VI characteristics of the Zener diode. So when the diode is connected in the forward bias, the slope is naturally as when the diode is in the forward bias. But when the diode is connected in the reverse bias, as the Zener diode is connected in the reverse bias, it goes to the negative terminal, and this region from the knee point where the slope goes down, this region is known as breakdown region. Okay, so this is a Zener breakdown, where the I'll show here when this happen. This is a current which is a minimum current flows in the reverse voltage, and this is a maximum current flows where the in the reverse voltage. So this is a knee point here, and this point from where the current flows through the circuit is known as the Zener voltage, or we can say a point from which the current starts flowing. Okay, so what is Zener breakdown? It is a type of breakdown observed in the reverse bias p-n junction that has a high doping concentration on both sides of junction. Means when we apply this reverse bias, and the p-n junction must be a heavily doped, the high doping concentration on the both side. Hence this field is enough to break a covalent bonds, means when the electric field is generated to the depletion region, it has the enough power to break the covalent bonds in the p-n junction diode. So here the large number of electrons and holes produces and constitute the reverse saturation current. So this is known as Zener breakdown. Now avalanche breakdown. What is avalanche breakdown? So it is exactly opposite to the Zener breakdown. And now in the avalanche breakdown, the p-n junction must be a lightly doped. It is a lightly doped p-n junction. Okay. So because of this lightly doped p-n junction, the depletion region become high. So we can say this is a depletion region. This is a depletion region is large, and because of the depletion region is large, the electric field across the depletion region is not so strong to produce a Zener breakdown. So the current will not flow through this when the depletion region is large. Now for this, when we apply a negative voltage, minimum 6 volt is required for this Zener breakdown. You can see this is a slope of the Zener breakdown and this is outer slope of the avalanche breakdown. For the avalanche breakdown, it requires a near about 8 volts. So this is the basic concept of Zener diode. Hope you like this video. So please subscribe to my channel, like the video, press the bell icon and comment if you have some query regarding to the Zener diode. See you in the next video. Thank you.